In 331 BC, Alexander's army of the Hellenic League meet the Persian army of Darius III near Gavgamela. In November 333 BC, Alexander had won the Battle of Issos. Darius had retreated to Babylon, where he regrouped with the remaining army. He ordered Mazaeus to guard the crossing of Euphrates near Thapsacos with 3,000 cavalry. He fled when Greek army approached to cross the river. After crossing Euphrates, Alexander managed to cross Tigris. According to some historians, Darius allowed Alexander to cross the two rivers in order to guide him to the battlefield of his own choice. Darius chose a flat open plain where he could deploy his larger forces. His soldiers flattened the terrain before the battle to give his 200 war chariots the best conditions. The main Persian army numbered about 200,000 men. Also, there were 200,000 skiffed chariots, 15 war elephants, and about 5,000 Greek mercenaries. The Greek army consisted of 31,000 heavy infantry and 9,000 light infantry, consisting mainly of peltasts with some archers. The size of the Greek mounted arm was about 7,000. Darius placed himself in the center with his best infantry, as was the tradition among Persian kings. He was surrounded by, on his right, the Carian cavalry, Greek mercenaries, and Persian horse guards. In the right center, he placed Persian foot guards, the Indian cavalry, and his archers. The Macedonian were divided into two, with the right side under the direct command of Alexander, and the left of Parmenion. Alexander fought with his companion cavalry. With it were the Paeonian and Greek light cavalry. The mercenary cavalry was divided into two groups, veterans on the flank of the right and the rest in front of the Agrians and Greek archers, who were stationed next to the phalanx. The right center were Cretan mercenaries. Behind them were Thessalian cavalry under Philip. Alexander began by ordering his infantry to march in phalanx formation. They advanced with the wings echeloned back at 45 degrees to lure the Persian cavalry to attack. While the phalanxes battled the Persian infantry, Darius sent a large part of his cavalry and some of his regular infantry to attack Parmenion's forces on the left. Alexander began to ride all the way to the edge of the right flank, accompanied by his companion cavalry. His plan was to draw as much of the Persian cavalry as possible to the flanks, to create a gap within the enemy line, where a decisive blow could then be struck at Darius in the center. The This required almost perfect timing and Alexander himself to act first. He would force Darius to attack. In the end, Darius attacked. The Scythian cavalry from the Persian left wing opened the battle by attempting to flank Alexander's extreme right. The Greek troops managed to defeat their Persian counterparts, which would be vital for the success of Alexander's decisive attack. Darius launched his chariots at those troops under Alexander's personal command. Many of the chariots were intercepted by the Agrianians and other javelin throwers. At the end, the Hypaspists attacked and eliminated the survivors. Alexander disengaged his companions and prepared for the decisive attack. He formed his units into a giant wedge, with him leading the charge. The Persian infantry at the center was still fighting the phalanxes, hindering any attempts to counter Alexander's charge. This large wedge then smashed into the weakened Persian center, taking out the Darius Royal Guard and the Greek mercenaries. Darius was in danger of being cut off and he broke and ran, with the rest of his army following him. Parmenion's wing was apparently encircled by the cavalry of the Persian right wing. Being attacked from all sides, it was in a state of confusion. Alexander decided to help him instead of pursuing Darius. Alexander's companions crushed Parthian and Indian cavalry. Parmenion counterattacked and the Persian right was slaughtered. Battle of Avgamila was a disastrous defeat for the Persians and one of Alexander's finest victories.